So, dear student, in class 9 motion segment, the next we are discussing here the problem related to XT graph or position time graph. Let very first we begin the first problem. It is written that if an object starts journey from origin and travel 2 meter towards positive x axis in time 5 seconds, it means what we can interpret the physical situation. Suppose this is the origin, an object is here. And this is a situation at t equal to 0, and coordinate of the origin we all know very well, that is 0 comma 0. And it is given to us in time 5 seconds, the object travel, the distance t equal to 5 seconds, object travel the distance that is given by 2 meter towards plus x axis, it means this coordinate is 2 comma 0. Then you reverse the direction of motion. Now we will reverse the direction of motion toward this side, we change the direction of motion, and next 10 seconds, it means this is 5, and next 10 seconds means we have to add 10, 5 plus 10 is 15, he travels 7 meter, it means in the 15, this distance is 7 meter, which is traveled by the person. If this distance is traveled 7 meter, I hope we can easily say this is 2, this is 7, so this coordinate where the person is reaching, we can say this coordinate can be written as minus 5 comma 0, and here time is taken as 15 seconds. This is the physical interpretation of this situation. Now what is required? Plot the displacement time and distance time graph and interpret this graph. We have to plot two graphs. One is between distance and time, between distance and time, and another graph between displacement and time. So children, you just observe the situation which I am highlighting. From t equal to 0 to t equal to 5, the direction of motion is same, it is not changing. So distance and displacement graph will be exactly same, no difference. And I think it is not written, but you have to assume it, that object is moving with a constant uniform speed or constant uniform velocity for t equal to 0 to t equal to 5 seconds. And so for such uniform motion graph, we know the graph will be straight line passing through the origin like this. It means it doesn't matter, we are plotting the graph for the displacement or distance, when directional motion is not changing here, we will say t equal to 5 second, this is also 2 coordinate, and t equal to 5 second, this is also 2 coordinate. When you are writing, please mention here time is measured in second, and here please write distance and displacement is measured in meter. But children, now come to the next part of the journey. Again, I am highlighting this part. All of you just check it. Now, what is happening? For this journey, I am discussing when the person changes the direction of motion like this. For this journey, what is happening? Direction is changing. It means both the graph cannot be same, because we know very well displacement can be negative, can be positive, can be zero, but distance cannot be negative, cannot be zero. It is always positive. It means for distance time graph, the graph will be again in the same direction. For displacement time graph, the graph will reverse the situation. And we can interpret one more physical situation here. If you observe, somewhere at some time, particle will come at the origin again. It means if you want to plot the graph between displacement and time will be like this. And for the distance and time, the graph will be like this. What is indication here? I am labeling the graph first. We can say this is the time 15 seconds, and this is the journey. I think this is 2 plus 7, this is 9 meter. This coordinate is 9 meter. I have written here 9, I think it is visible to you. 2 meter plus 7 meter, because distance always added, so this is 9 meter. And here how I will do it. Just check the situation for this situation. Again, I have to plot some coordinate. Okay, time, I think all of you agree, it will be 15. But what is the value of this coordinate? If you minutely observe, at t equal 15 second, displacement is minus 5. It means this coordinate will be minus 5. I hope it is clear to all of you. Now we will plot the, we will just interpret the situation. If I interpret the situation for O to A, it doesn't matter, I am observing the distance or displacement, situation is same. So let us discuss this part also here. Just a second. Okay. Now we discuss. Firstly, we are discussing the OA part for the distance as well as for displacement. I hope all of you are intelligent. If this is the graph between distance and time we have discussed earlier, the slope of the graph will give you the speed. So from O to A, it is visible to all of you, speed is constant for both the situation. So you will say slope is given by, this is 2 upon 5 meter per second for both the situation. Here slope will give the speed and here slope will give the velocity. That we should know very well. Now, we take another reason for A to B, here also for A to B. We take the region A to B, here also we take the region A to B. Now, here if I have to calculate the slope, I think all of you know, we have to measure this distance, we have to measure this distance, then we have to divide. So this is 9, this is 2, so this is 7, this is 15, this is 5, this is 10. So what is the speed in this situation for A to B region? 7 by 10 equal to 0.7 meter per second. And here you are calculating 2 by 5, it is 0.4. Children, I hope it is visible to all of you. You can't say that this straight line having the same slope. Here slope is more. So you have to just deviate the path of the straight line. Now I have to calculate the velocity in this region because displacement time graph gives me velocity. So here we calculate the velocity for A to B region. You just observe the situation. We make the right angle triangle again. I think it is visible to all of you. This is the obtuse angle, it means velocity will be negative. Now what is the slope of the graph? This is minus 5, this is 2, I hope it is visible to all of you, this is 7. And what is the time taken? What is the time taken if this is 7? This is the 10, 7 divided by 10, I will say it is minus 0.7 meter per second. So this is the very first situation which I want to convey to you. All of you go through it. If anywhere any doubt, you can ask me doubt counter and I will reply there. We move for the next situation. Okay, children. Again, we have given same XT graph. Pattern is little bit different. And from the graph, we have to observe the distance, displacement, average speed, average velocity. Firstly, I will calculate the distance table. So, we are solving the first part. There is a total distance table. I hope the time is visible to all of you. 0 second, 2 second, 4 second, 5 second, 6 second. And distance, we all know, it is always added. So if I mark some point on the graph, O, A, B, C, D, something like that. If I calculate the total distance, X total, we will say X from O to A, X from A to B, X from B to C, X from C to D. And if you calculate it, you will get X from O to A is 40, then again from A to B is also 40. I am not subtracting it because I am calculating the distance and distance is always added. X B to C is 20 meter. Again, you are giving the negative side, but you have to add it because it is distance. And then again, X C to D is 20 meter. When you solve it, 448. 10, 12, 120 meter. It is the distance traveled. So we have discussed the first part. Distance traveled, it is given by 120 meter. Now we are solving the second part. In the second part, we have to calculate the displacement. And I think everybody knows displacement, we have to keep the direction also in your mind. And if anything is moving the reverse side, we have to write the minus sign for the calculation of the displacement. So, second part, that is displacement. Look at the situation. I hope some of you can directly calculate it. Displacement is known as the final position minus initial position. You just look at the graph. In the graph, I hope it is quite visible to all of you. This is the initial position, t equal to 0. At t equal to 6 seconds, again you are at the 0. It means initial position is also 0 and final position is also 0. So 0 minus 0 is this 0. So displacement is 0 meter. We can also calculate 40, minus 40, minus 20, plus 20. That also we can do. But it is directly visible to us. So at t equal to 0, we are at the origin. At t equal to 6 seconds, we are at the origin. So displacement is 0. Now we are coming to the third part. In the third part, we have to calculate the speed, average speed. And average speed depends on the distance, not on the displacement. We know the formula. So if we calculate the average speed for the third situation, average speed, we will say it is known as the total distance upon total time. Total distance upon total time. And quite visible to all of you, distance traveled is 120, total time is 6 seconds. So our answer is 20 meters per second. This is the average speed. Now we are coming to the fourth segment. In the fourth segment, we have to calculate average velocity. All of you know, average velocity related with the displacement upon time, and displacement is 0. So our average velocity will be 0 meter per second. Of course, you have to write the meter per second also. So this is the second problem of the day. We discuss the next problem. Okay. Here again we are having the xt graph. You have to find the velocity of the particle at t equal to 1 second and t equal to 4 seconds. And after calculating the velocity, we have to sketch the vt graph also, velocity time graph also. Look at the situation. If you observe the graph, let me check, change the color. Okay. If you observe the graph from O region to A region, it is quite visible to all of you, the graph is a straight line. And slope is same everywhere. If I write the slope, it is same everywhere because same angle. We have discussed in the last video lecture. Everywhere theta is same. So our slope is same. So what we are getting? We are getting that speed is same from O to A. Or velocity is same from O to A. Velocity is same at every point from O to A. So from O to A path, if I calculate the velocity, velocity is the slope of the displacement time graph. And what is the slope? Slope we can easily calculate. This is the perpendicular distance. This is 8. And this is 2. So it is 4 meter per second. So the first part, what is the velocity of the particle at time t equal to 1 second that we have calculated? It is known as the 4 meter per second. Now we are moving to the second part of the situation. In the second part, if you look this graph, I hope it is visible that this graph, of course it is also a straight line graph. But if you see the slope, slope is same everywhere with slope, I told you angle with the x-axis. But this slope is obtuse. And when this slope is obtuse, velocity is negative. So I calculate for the second part of the journey. Velocity is the slope of the graph, slope this perpendicular distance. Again it is 8. And this is the time taken, 6 minus 2, this is 4. But minus I have to put because the obtuse angle is there. So it is minus 2 meter per second. So we say, for t equal to 4 second, our velocity is minus 2 meter per second. Now, we have to plot the vt graph also. Let us plot here only. Just a second. Okay. We take some space. So children, basically what I conveyed to you, and again I am telling you, if xt graph is given, and you observe the xt graph, with the help of the slope, we can calculate the velocity easily. Now I am converting this graph into vt graph. here is the velocity. Of course, it is meter, it is seconds, it must be in meter per second. And here is the time, and time is in seconds. Now I mark the time axis values, all the values. It is given to me 0, it is given to me 2, it is given to me 6. Now from 0 to 2 second my velocity is fixed, 4 meter per second, it is constant. Suppose I say this is 2, this is 4. So my velocity is constant. For this reason I say my velocity is like this. Now from t equal to 2 second to t equal to 6 second, again velocity is constant, minus 2. Let I say this is minus 2. Suppose. It means from this onward the graph will be like this. So this is the pattern of the graph which we obtain. We move to the next problem. Okay. All if you just observe the graph and you have to comment only velocity, just only comment, no calculations required because you are in class 9. Look at the situation. If you observe this graph and this graph, I think one thing is directly visible to you. Both the graph are the curve graph or curve segment. It means velocity is not constant. It is variable or it is changing. Velocity is changing. The very first thing which you are getting here, velocity change. Because if the graph was a straight line passing like this, then you can say velocity is constant, but it is not like that. So we will say very first observation, if the graph is a curve, we will say if the graph between the x t is curve, we will say velocity is variable or changing. Now here if you observe the velocity at every point, we plot the slope like this slope, like this slope. I hope it is visible to all of you. In the slope theta is acute, and when the theta is acute, velocity is positive. And you observe the slope here, here we plot the slope, here we plot the slope, everywhere theta is obtuse, and when theta is obtuse we will say velocity is negative. So I hope now you can easily comment by observing the graph. If the graph is curve, velocity is variable, it is changing, not constant. But at least we can say velocity is positive or negative. Well, at the when the theta is acute, velocity is positive, and when theta is obtuse, velocity is negative. Now we can discuss the acceleration, but that is not part of this platform. Of course, in the advanced lecture I will discuss and elaborate this graph so that you can get the acceleration retardation also here. We move to the next situation. Again you have to observe the graph. Again one thing directly coming to your brain, that this is a variable graph. It means velocity is not constant, velocity is changing. So what we will say? Velocity is continuously changing. Very first thing. Now where the velocity is positive, where the velocity is negative, again you can see the slope. You just plot the slope here, you just plot the slope here, you just plot the slope here, you just plot the slope here. Here theta angle with the x-axis is positive, acute, and here theta is obtuse. So what we will say? Here the velocity is positive for the journey, and here the velocity is negative. Now what is acceleration? Again I am telling you, I will discuss in the advanced section. So if some of you are interested, you can observe the advanced section videos also. Again, one more situation. We have given the position time graph, and we have to plot, find the velocity directly visible to you. From position time graph we have to calculate the velocity. Velocity is given by slope of position time graph, x t graph. What is slope? If I calculate the slope here, I make the right angle triangle by joining these two points. This distance is 30 minus 10, that is 20, and this distance is again, I hope, 30 minus this is 0, so this is 30. Slope I calculate 20 by 3, you can say 2 by 3 meter per second. Next segment, next problem. Okay, here we have to fill the blank space. In the given distance time graph, speed is increasing, decreasing, remains same, or can you predict from C to D? You observe the graph for C to D only. this graph you have to observe. This is a XT graph, and I told you if XT graph is straight line, obviously speed velocity is constant, and because everywhere again theta is same, theta is not changing, theta is the angle drawn from the x-axis, it is constant. It means the answer of this problem is speed remains same from C to D region. Next situation. Ravi traveled from his house to the shop and then came back. Oh, so it should be his journey. His journey is shown on the graph. Work out his speed in kilometer per hour when he was traveling. I hope it is visible to you. Ravi was traveling for this path. After that, he stops at the shop. So we have to calculate the speed only the first highlighted part. How we will calculate? If there is XT graph, see, this is his journey. If there is XT graph, then slope of the XT graph gives the speed. So here I calculate the slope. The speed is, this is the right angle triangle. Let me choose different color here. This is the right angle triangle. Okay. So what is this distance? This is 30 meter. And what is this time? I hope it is in 7 o'clock. It means 60 minutes and then 15 minutes extra. It is 75 minutes. So, but we generally determine in meter per second. So, we will write speed is distance upon time. Distance is 30. And it is given in kilometers. Okay. We write kilometer. Then it is 75 minutes. You can also write in 30 kilometer, 75 upon 60 hours. Now you can calculate yourself. I am leaving as an exercise for you. We move to the next part of the situation. Work out how long Ravi spent at the shop. I hope I told you, he stayed at the shop for this time interval only. And if you quietly observe it, you will say, this time is only 15 minutes because from 7:15 to 7:30 Ravi was at shop. So he write it his journey again. I think this is a typing error. Next segment. Again it is his journey. Okay. Ravi travels home from the shop at 60 km per hour. Complete the journey. Complete the graph. Children, Ravi traveled the distance which is visible to you, it is 30 kilometer. This is the distance. And speed is given you 60 kilometer per hour. How much time Ravi will take? Time is given by distance upon speed. What is distance? 30. What is speed? 60 kilometer per hour. We can say 1 by 2 hours. It means 30 minutes. It means at 7:30, he was at the shop, he started the journey, perfectly at 8 o'clock, he will reach. So we plot the graph. From 7:30 to 8, we join the straight line. This is the graph. I think my head is just vibrated. You have to use the scale and then you can make the straight line. Okay, one more situation I'm telling. There are four graphs between displacement time and I have to convert, or you have to convert into velocity time. We discuss the first situation. In the first situation, again quite obvious to all of you, by observe the straight line graph, you will see velocity is constant. Then observe slope. I have known you are expert in observing the slope. Slope is constant everywhere because theta is constant everywhere. What is the speed? What is the velocity for this journey? I calculate the slope of the graph. Suppose I say this is this distance is 7 and this is also 7. It means it is 1 meter per second. So my VT graph for this journey will be like this. Then I move to the second graph. In the second graph, it is visible to you from 0 to 2 second my velocity is constant, but 2 second onward I am at rest. It means perfectly 2 second onward my velocity is 0. But what is the velocity from 0 to 2 second? This is my 6, this is my 2, so 6 divided by 2, that is given by 3. So velocity for this region is 3, that we can say. Come to the third part. Again in the third part, it is observed, I think it is visible to all of you. From 4 to 7 second object is at rest. It means 4 to 7 second object is at rest. Directly visible to us. And from 0 to 2 second slope is of course constant, but theta is obtuse, so it will be in the negative side. And from 2 to 4 second slope is constant, but theta is acute, so velocity is positive side. Firstly, we calculate the negative side velocity. We take this part of the graph. This is 6. This is 2, so this is 4. This is 0, this is 2, so this is 2. So 4 divided by 2 is 2, but negative side, so it is minus 2 for this path. The next segment here, I say this is the right angle triangle. This is 4, this is 2, so this is 2. This is 2, this is 4, this is also 2. 2 divided by 2, that is 1. So this is the graph pattern for the third region. Come to the fourth region. In the fourth region, it is visible to all of you. This is the situation at which your position is not changing. It means from 6 to 7 seconds, you are at rest. Quite visible to you. And from 0 to 4 seconds, speed is positive and constant. You measure the slope. This is 7, this is 5, so this is 2, this is 4, this is 0, this is 4. So 2 by 4 I calculate, that is 0.5. It means up to this region, this is, suppose I say this is 0.5 point. We make the line up to 4 second. What is after 4 second? 4 to 6 second, it is visible to all of you, theta is obtuse, so velocity is negative. We measure the slope. This is 7, this is 1, so this distance is 6. I say, I can use different color here, so you get the better idea. This distance is 6. And this is 4, this is 6, this is 2. And 6 divided by 2 is 3, but theta is obtuse. So this is minus 3. It means for this journey, it is minus 3 from 4 to 6. So, children, today we have discussed plenty of situation for the XT graph. You please practice on it. Next segment, we will discuss some another graphs also. Thank you.